you.
Tell me a little, tell us about Skeeter.
Skeeter actually was me when I was in my mid-30s. Okay. She's juggling, she's a reporter.
So that wasn't very long ago.
No, just, you know, weeks ago.
Weeks.
She has children, she has a husband, she has a full-time job, she's juggling a house, taking care of all of that. She cares deeply about her career, she cares deeply about journalism and the role it plays in the community. She cares equally deeply about her children and her family, and she walks that tightrope that many of us walk or have walked.
Your first book, Where's Billy, is about, well, I don't want to give anything away, but it's, she has children that she cares a lot about. Mm-hmm. She's struggling with a marriage that's not working terribly well, and all of a sudden she is pulled into this story about something that's going on at the Mall of America.
Right.
And you got some great reviews for that first book.
Yeah, I was delighted. Publishers yeah. Weekly in particular liked it a lot, yeah. And Armchair Interviews, mm-hmm. Star Tribune gave it a really nice review, the Pioneer Press gave it a really nice review. I was very fortunate.
So was it hard to get your first book published? Tell us a little bit about that.
There's a leading question.
Is it hard to get your first book published? Yes, it's very difficult. I published it first online. It was up on Kindle first in January in 2009. And that was self-published on Kindle.
Right.
And I had some sales. And because I was able to demonstrate some sales and some interest, Noden Press then picked it up.
Right.
But yes, it was difficult.
Was it reviewed once it became a paper?
Yeah, Armchair Interviews reviewed it when it was online, but when it came out in paper was when I got paper reviews.
BW.
Yeah.
Did you notice, I'm just curious, did you notice the Kindle book sales go up after it had been published in paper?
You know, they've been about the same.
Okay.
I think they're independent, actually. Okay. I think paper and Kindle are independent.
Okay. I think you're right. I think they're playing to different audiences.
Yeah, really. Totally different. I don't think one is stealing from the other. If anything, I think they're synergistic, to tell you the truth.
I think you're absolutely right. I agree with that.
And it's now up on iBooks, too, which didn't exist when I mm-hmm. originally mm-hmm. put it up on Kindle.
Mm-hmm. Now, you've written a second book.
Yes.
It's Whose Hand.
Yep.
And it's about an old guy fishing out in Lake Harriet.
This is a great setup.
It is a great setup. Finds a hand.
Fishes a hand out of the Lake Harriet, and he pulls it up, and just as he's pulling it up, an airplane is coming in over the lake, and if you live near there, they do that. And he just totally freaks and loses his favorite rod and reel and the hand back into the lake.
I love it. That's a great setup.
So
Skeeter has moved
our intrepid reporter Skeeter did such a good job in her previous job. She is now covering a beat called Missing Persons. Mm-hmm. And so her job is to figure out whose hand it is. And there are...
I love the cover, by the way.
Do you? Good. Yep. Thank you. There are three possibilities of who this hand could belong to. A Russian furrier, a high school student who's got a full ride to the University of Minnesota waiting for her, or a research director for a medical device manufacturer. Or nobody, because maybe the old man is lying.
An old fisherman's story.
Yes,
one that
it
got
may
away.
Be, yes.
The hand that got away. I've told that story myself.
Yeah, there you go. They get away from you all the time.
Well, I've only read part of it, and I think it's a terrific book.
Thank you.
I think you get a great setup in this book.
I'm very excited about it.
Yeah. Who's the publisher?
Well, Noden has expressed an interest in it. He's waiting until Norton Stillman, the publisher there, wants to see the full manuscript. Right now it's in editing.
But will it go to Kindle first?
It will go to Kindle first, yeah. I'll do it the same way I did it before.
It isn't actually published yet.
No. Yeah. It'll be up on Kindle and iBook, hopefully within a few months.
It's still an editorial.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's still in process right now.
I'm seeing a trend here in titles. Where's Billy?
Whose hand?
Do you think you'll continue with that? I think it's kind of a nice platform.
That's what
I've
been thinking about. I have an idea for the third book, and why here is what I was thinking of for the next one.
Two-word titles, always starting with one of those words.
And a question, but a question mark. And the question mark, the idea is that it makes the reader think a little bit.
Right away.
Right away.
Out of the starting gate.
And it lends, it's instant mystery, too.
That's great.
So that's the plan, yes.
One of the things that I like very much about your book is that Skeeter Hughes is, in essence, kind of working for the dinosaur
of
media.
Absolutely. And that's a theme, particularly in the second book. She's worried, in addition to all the other things she's trying to juggle, she's worried every day that she's going to have a job. And she's worried every other day that her husband, who works for the competing newspaper, is going to have a job. And the pressures that are continual because there aren't enough people anymore to do the kind of job that everyone would like to do. So yeah, she's working print and wondering why.
Well, tell us a little bit about you are a tireless promoter. And we try and promote too, you know, but you really hit the ground running, I felt, of all the authors.
And you're
that
really
I know.
Using the media, the new technology a lot in your promotion.
So you're on Twitter and Facebook?
I have almost 2,600 Twitter followers that have been built up over the last four or five months. I have a consultant who's been helping me with that. And also I have the Judith Yates Borger Book Booster Club.
That's it, on Facebook.
which my son put together for me.
That's cool.
Long ago, before this whole Twitter thing got started.
So what's a typical tweet from you? What would it be?
Well, I had one that said, I'm going off tonight to for the Minnesota Crime Wave interview, and I will be tweeting later with more information on where and when you can see it.
A shout out for us.
Yeah. Thanks. There you go.
Yeah. That helps.
I don't
know
where we are in time. Can I ask more questions?
Of course you can.
Of course I can.
You just
keep
on going until somebody shuts you up. That's the way this works here, remember?
You know, I'm very curious because e-books, Kindle, iBooks, the different various formats, this is all so new. And, of course, it's what everybody's talking about in the industry.
Absolutely.
How did you, you already obviously had your books in a digital format. How did you find out how to upload these to these various, iBooks?
I mean, I Googled how to upload the format.
Into and, iBook, too?
Well, what I did was for Kindle, actually, first I uploaded it onto Kindle, and it's very simple.
It is. I do that. It
took a minute and a half.
If you start with a clean manuscript.
Yeah, the trick is formatting it right to begin with.
Yep.
Wow.
That took me, fooling around with the formatting took me a day and a half. Now I can do it very quickly because I learned. But you just kind of follow the directions very specifically.
They have really good directions on Kindle.
They really do.
Unlike some of the other
platforms. Have you done Smashwords?
And Smashwords was the other one that I did. And that also went very fast. I'm having some problems with Smashwords. Supposedly, iBook uses Smashwords format, but I've gone through and have bought my book through iBook just to make sure that the process works. And I'm not getting. They've charged me for it, but they haven't paid me for it.
Quickly, for viewers who don't have the slightest idea what you're talking about, explain Smashwords.
Well, there are a number of platforms that you can use to get your ebooks out there.
About 15 now.
And Smashwords is one of them. It's where you can upload a book, and then it's distributed to the various readers that there are out there, like the Nook, Barnes & Noble Nook, the Kindle from
Yeah, that's
Amazon.
The difference between between Smashwords and Kindle. Kindle is a wholly owned separate unit. Mm-hmm. They do buy books, they do buy manuscripts from Kindle. But what Smashwords does is does a universal format that is then made available to any e-book reader, any e-reader that exists.
Mm-hmm. That's what it says. However.
That's what it says.
However.
And
however.
And it works most of the time for most of the platforms, but it's not universally perfected yet.
Yeah.